Welcome back. Well, tonight we begin a series of special reports about the devastation and the fight to cure Alzheimer's. The specials will lead up to the Walk to End Alzheimer's in October in downtown Oklahoma City.
Tonight we're focusing on family caregivers of Alzheimer's patients. Chances are you may be one, or maybe you know somebody who is.
Because there are a lot of them. It can be a crushing task. But some caregivers have found a way to take a swing back at Alzheimer's.
It's just gets you right there, you know. So it brings back past memories.
Alzheimer's Association volunteer Lynda Sales talking about her caretaker years for her mother, afflicted with Alzheimer's.
It's a very hard time. We all struggle during those times.
And the number of caretakers in Oklahoma is staggering.
And we know that there are 65,000 Oklahomans living with the disease, and there are 224,000 caregivers need our services.
And family and friends of Alzheimer's patients provide hundreds of millions of dollars of free but emotionally draining care to their loved ones, while racking up large health care costs for themselves.
Sometimes the caretaker can even get physically ill from everything that they have to do.
Oh, sure, yeah. You even believe that you're getting it yourself, you know, it puts you in that kind of a mindset.
Ford, you were probably what?
Seven or eight?
Yeah.
Max?
Do you remember taking this picture?
I do, because we all got to go swimming after.
That was probably prior to any sort of signs of Alzheimer's.
Yeah.
The Kemps of Oklahoma City talking about the patriarch of the family, Kenneth Kemp, who passed away from Alzheimer's. Brad remembers when his dad began showing the early signs of the disease.
My dad was a big reader, and he got to where he couldn't read anymore because he couldn't remember what he was reading.
And with all family caretakers, it's hard watching the disease progress.
It's tough. You know, you have an image of your father, your mother, your entire life, and...
They're indestructible, you think?
Yes.
Yeah.
So Brad and his family turned to the Alzheimer's Association for help.
They walked us through the disease, what to expect from my dad, what he was going through, how to be a good caregiver.
And now both Brad and Lynda have found a way to fight back against the disease that robbed them of their loved ones. They do it by volunteering through the Alzheimer's Association.
These people here are the nicest people I have ever met. And they look after me too.
And by listening to those wanting to volunteer, the experts here care and know where best volunteers can serve.
Some of our volunteers get very emotional telling me their story, which in turn I get emotional listening to it. It doesn't get old listening to the stories. Everybody's story is different. And so it's always interesting to hear what brought them to us. What was their passion to get them to our door?
And now you're on the board. Why did you get on the board?
After my father passed away, I thought it was a way to honor him.
Lynda works in the office, getting literature ready and answering phone calls for help. And like Brad, remembering her parent, who she helped all along the way down the challenging road of Alzheimer's disease.
If I can just give somebody some hope, pay back, not just to the community, but in a way that will really be a tribute to her, I think she would be proud of me.
You bet you will. And the walk is October 5th at Oklahoma City's Bicentennial Park downtown. Mike, our friend Mike Morgan, and his wife Marla are once again emceeing the walk for us.
For more information on signing up, or maybe you'd like to volunteer, log on to KFOR.com/AllsWalk.